Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Kingdom Hearts. Last time, we left off with this little cutscene here, if you remember, with this big freaking tiger head made of sand. Oh, yeah, so this tiger head is, if you remember, the Cave of Wonders from the movie. Basically, we need to beat it into submission for it to allow us to enter its mouth. That's what she said. Anyway, so yeah, basically you gotta hit its eyes. God, this is a horrible, horrible episode. Anyway, so nothing really works against it except for melee. I'm not sure if thunder and like fire and blizzard work. They might, but I'm not completely sure. Anyway, and while you're focusing on its eyes, it will also spew out enemies and projectiles at Donald, Goofy, and yourself. So be careful. Donald should basically take care of any healing that's required in the group, just like that. I would suggest using arrow in this fight for Sora while you're on top of this tiger's head, mostly because it'll help you from being knocked back and you won't take so much damage when you do get hit. So basically that'll keep Donald from having to heal you and he can focus on healing himself and Goofy. So just keep that in mind. Now, when you're attacking the tiger's eyes, after you attack one eye for a certain amount of time, it'll go blank, I believe, and you'll have to attack the other eye. It's basically when you get him down half of his health. So there goes Donald. So let's heal him. Yeah, you don't want Donald to be out of commission for this fight, because you want him and Goofy to take care of the Heartless down there and keep them busy so you can focus on the eyes. If you don't do that, then they'll come after you in spades, and that makes it really rough. Now, along with the abilities that we've seen so far, the tiger head also has the ability to spew out basically like a big old gust of sand, which can do quite a bit of damage. Nothing to be worried about, but you don't want to get hit by hit so freely and then not think you're going to be able to walk away without being able to heal. So just keep that in mind. You'll see it here in a few moments, I think, actually coming up. I don't know why. I keep trying to, basically, in order to avoid it, you kind of want to go towards the side or the back of the tiger's head. You should be doing this anyway, really, if you're not on top of his head, because that is where you go to get it on top. Like I said, you should really be letting Donald and Goofy handle the ads. Listen to me talking like this is World of Warcraft. Handle the extra enemies that come out. Here's a sandblast, by the way, coming up in like a few seconds. Boom. Yeah, it's really just him summoning an enemy, but you can't get hit by it, so be careful. So let's take this moment to climb on his head, try not to get hit, and remember, at this point you should be doing pretty well, mostly because that's actually the attack that I was thinking of. At least I think it's sand. It might be fire? I'm not actually sure now at this point whether it's fire or sand. But I keep missing my chance to climb on his head. Anyway, so get rid of the big body, or the fat bandit, as quickly as you can, because it is really annoying. And this tiger is really annoying too. Come on, just stay down. Stay down. There we go. No! God damn it. Okay. On his next nosedive, we should get him, and that should be the end of the fight. I think after a certain amount of time, he does stop summoning Heartless, but I'm not completely sure on that. At least he's not doing it right now. So yeah, I want Donald and Goofy to focus on the eye when there aren't any Heartless out. And yeah, that's basically the gist of this fight. I mean, I don't know why it's taking him so long to get down. I mean, it would be really nice if you could take a nosedive for me, tiger head. Come on. Do I need to, like, go in front of you or something? Are you kidding me? Come on. Oh, God. Come on. Are you gonna do it? It usually never takes this long for me. I don't know why it's being so finicky. Oh, okay. So he I guess the problem was he had an enemy stuck in his throat. Here we go. Here we go. Go, 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 go. No! What was I doing? What was I doing? God, I hate myself. I'm sorry, guys. This fight normally does not take this long. There we go. Got onto his head. Alright. Now I'm just gonna sit tight till he comes back up. And you're gonna focus on the eye. And that's it. That is this boss fight in gist. We even leveled. Look at that. So many levels. So little time. Great. So after that, the tiger head becomes tame, and you'll be able to actually jump inside its mouth and continue. Now, my suggestion is, before heading to the Cave of Wonders, is to go back to town, rest up, save, replenish your character's health and MP before heading in here. I, on the other hand, was in the middle of thinking, oh, I'm recording for an LP, so I need to rush in. This is a mistake. I don't die, but it is really rough in here before healing and, you know, coming prepared. As you see, Donald's dead. And you don't want your characters dying against things that are non-bosses because, well, it causes trouble for you. Trust me. They do gain experience still, even if they're dead. Don't worry about that. But it's just you don't have the extra help that you normally would. Now, I know some of you are thinking, but Donald and Luffy aren't even really help. Well, when you're playing in expert mode and you're not exactly super leveled, yeah, they do provide quite amount of assistance to you. At least as meat shields, at the very least, you know, so keep that in mind. Now, see that rolling ball there? You want to watch out, because if you do get in the way of it, it will hit you constantly, do quite a bit of damage, and send you into the pit. I don't want to fall down to the pit quite just yet, because, well, we'll head down there later, but right now it's just not on my list of things to do. Now you see Donald's dead again. That's mostly because this fat bandit up here, I didn't have the MP in order to you know, cast gravity on him and make him a lot easier, so he's taking quite a bit of time to kill. There we go. That took out a nice chunk of his health. Now here's another problem. We got him in this corner, we can't hit his back because he's focusing on me. I'm thinking, okay, Goofy, come on, you can hit him, right? No, Goofy is, well, Goofy actually did it. Pulled it off pretty nicely there, actually. So after that, I'm gonna use a potion. Okay, never mind. So let's open up this chest. We got a Mega Aether. It's not bad. I'm going to use a camping set and replenish everyone's health and MP because I need it desperately. I could have saved myself that camping set if I had just gone back to town, but you know, it's not a big deal. Anyway, let's put potions on everybody so that way they can, you know, not die so easily and actually heal each other. And, Aladdin, don't worry about him. Yeah, that's pretty good. There's a treasure chest over there. We can't get it right now, so don't worry about it. And, yeah, I'm pretty much gonna head to the next room and call this an episode. So, yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. Sorry that boss fight took much longer than it normally does. And, see you guys next time. This is Kevin saying bye-bye.